Welcome. We will discuss successive differentiation. What it means? That means if we are doing first derivative, then second order derivative, then third order derivative, in this way if we are going on doing, can we find a general formula for any order of derivative or not? Let us take one example. Suppose y equals to ax plus b whole to the power k. So derivative what we will get? We are knowing k into ax plus b whole to the power k minus 1. Again derivative of ax plus b is a. So that means this one is coming. If we are doing y2, then what is there? We are getting a k, this is there. Then k minus 1 will come here and ax plus b whole to the power k minus 1 minus 1, that is k minus 2, into again derivative of ax plus b will give you a. We can do one more derivative. Let us see what is coming. Y3. Now this is a into a is a square k k minus 1. Now this k minus 2 will come. Ax plus b whole to the power k minus 3. And again derivative of ax plus b will be one more a. So this one we can write in this way, a cube into, suppose k, k minus 1, k minus 2. Can I write this one in this style? If I am saying in k, p, 3, permutation of 3 things from k things is k into k minus 1 into k minus 2 into ax plus b whole to the power k minus 3. Now see, this 3 is here, 3 is here, 3 is here, 3 is here. We can get a general method. Same thing we can observe for 2 also it is there, for 1 also it is there. So from here we have to say yn equals to a to the power n k p n ax plus b whole to the power k minus n. It can be proved by the method of mathematical induction. So this is, in this way we can find the nth derivative. This method is known as successive differentiation. Okay, thank you.